Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Ask Professor Dan Show. I'm Dana Marie McNichol-Carter, your announcer for the evening. Now, tonight, we have a riveting competition between some of your favorite athletes here on Gonzaga's campus. Each contestant will be competing to win $500 that will be representing three clubs here on campus. Each of these clubs motivates the energy in the McCarthy Center. So let's get to know these contestants. First, we have Bree Baumann, a senior captain of the cheerleading squad that will be representing the Bulldog Band. Next, we have Connor Griffin, a sophomore men's Gonzaga basketball player who will be battling out for the Bomb Squad. And last but not least, we have Kacie Bosch, who will be playing for the Kennel Club. Thank you so much for joining us tonight, and let's go on over to Professor Dan, the host of the show tonight.
Thanks a lot, DMC, and thank you at home for joining us. Now you've got some work to do. We're going to take our brave contestants through a series of games where they can earn points to bet at the end of the show. That's when they'll gamble on which of these three questions you want to answer. Here we go. Is it, will campus construction ever end? Does your major define you? And what really goes on in campus security? Vote for the one you want to ask by tweeting at GUTVZags with the hashtag APD2015, and I'll answer the winning question at the end of the show. If our contestants guess right, and if they bet right, they could win 500 clams for the clubs they're representing. Let's meet them now. Hello, Kacie Bosch from Lethbridge, Alberta. You're the star of the women's basketball team, and you're representing the Kennel Club today.
Yeah.
We had a wonderful chance to get to know you a couple of days ago during rehearsals, and you told me about a hair-raising experience when people were heckling you. It was in a away gym, right?
Yeah.
What did these mean people say to you?
They said, go back to Disneyland.
They said, go back to Disneyland, and let me show everybody why, because you saw how beautiful Kacie is. They think she looks like Merida, the Disney princess from Brave. I want to know, what kind of a heckle is that? Hey, you're gorgeous. You look like a what school was this? Do you remember?
It was Raymond. Fans. Raymond High School.
Oh, in high school. Okay, mm-hmm. I kind of understand that.
Yeah.
All right, let's find out how much you know about the club you're representing. We're going to allow you to try to earn some points by answering a question about the Kennel Club. To get that, let's go to Amelia and Spencer in the live viewing party. Hey, guys.
Erin Greer, next year's Kennel Board president. Here's our first question.
How many years has the Kennel Club been around? 10 years, 30 years, or 50 years?
All right, their question to you. How many years has the Kennel Club been around? 10, 30, or 50? What do you think?
30.
30 is absolutely correct. There's 100 points. Quick, do you see how easy that is? Let's see if our next contestant can do the same for the Bomb Squad. Connor Griffin, a sophomore on the men's basketball team. Welcome to you. The weird thing is, you never get to see the Bomb Squad perform, right?
I'm not supposed to see them.
Yeah. Well, they always see you dance. We've got a picture, I think, of what some of your performance on the side. Does anything go into that? What are you thinking?
You know, me, Rem, and Dust are just trying to have a good time on the bench and find a way to bring energy to the team, and I think that's a successful way of doing it. Yeah.
You know, you have an incredible connection to our guest lecturer. You know, Coach Jerry Krause is here. He, of course, invented the breakaway rim, and you try to break his invention as often as you can.
Yes, this is true.
If the ball is round, you say, I can dunk this.
Yeah, I think of Jerry Krause.
A lot of fun. All right, let's find out how much you know about the Bomb Squad. So, Amelia and Spence, let's have another question from you guys.
Hey guys, I'm here with Kristen McNeely, next year's captain of the Gonzaga University Bomb Squad, and here is her question for Connor.
At what point during the basketball games does the Bomb Squad perform? Is it pregame, media timeout, or at halftime?
Ooh, that is a good one. All right, so their question to you, when does the Bomb Squad perform? During the pregame, during media timeouts, or during halftime?
Media timeouts.
It is, in fact, during media timeouts. Well done, 100 points for the Bomb Squad. And hello to our third contestant, Bree Baumann. And you're an athlete as well on the cheerleading squad.
Right.
You're playing for the Bulldog Band. How convenient, because right. You're always standing in front of them. You guys travel together. Was it like a family reunion in the live viewing party?
Yeah, kind of. It's nice. I feel like I know pretty much all three of these clubs we're representing.
Yeah. So. And I say athlete. Take a look at what Bree does on a regular basis when she is out there with the cheerleading squad. This is like behind the scenes as they're practicing. Is there a name for this other than frightening?
It's called a loaded QB, but we actually can't do them on the basketball court because they're illegal. So we
just put an illegal video on the awesome.
No, it's fine. It's practice and we're on a mat, but we can't roll up mats for the game.
That makes sense. So. Why did they choose you to be the flyer? Did it have anything to do with your shoe size?
No. Actually, all the girls on our team are flyers because we have a completely co-ed team. So there's one guy for every girl. Yeah. So every girl's a flyer.
And that was your fun fact during rehearsals.
Right.
You're a size...
3 in kids.
A size 3 in kids.
Yeah.
I have a granddaughter who's a size 2.
Right.
That must be a lot of fun. All right, so what about the Bulldog Band, Amelia and Spencer? You got some trivia for Bree?
Yes, we do. Next to me is our final club representative, drummer Nolan Woodard of the Bulldog Band. Here's his question.
What family of instruments are not involved in the Bulldog Band? Percussion, strings, or brass?
Good one. Okay, Bree, the question is, which one of these instruments is not represented in the Bulldog Band? Is it brass, percussion, or string?
String
is not there. We're tied, ladies and gentlemen. Each team right now has 100 points, but this round comes with a secret bonus. Before the show, we invited all of you to tweet your prediction of who will win. And it was a little bit neck and neck when the whole thing started. We had a late rush, and I will tell you that Connor Griffin and the Bomb Squad, you have a smile like you knew this was coming.
Oh, I mean, I had that late push, and hopefully that was enough to win, and it was.
It did it for this round. There's an extra 50 points there. Congratulations. After the break, we're going to get to know a little bit more about our clubs and what they would do with the prize money from our sponsor, which is Savory Creations tonight. They're also hosting the Pho Bar outside the live viewing party. Had a little bit myself. It was wonderful. And then later on, we'll have some academic trivia questions from GU professors all over campus. Thanks for watching the Ask Professor Dan Show on GUTV.
Thanks for reminding me.
Welcome back to the production control room at the Ask Professor Dan Show. Quick score update. We have Connor Griffin and the Bomb Squad with 150 points. And now to Maureen Mahoney with a little bit more from our producer.
Hello. As explained before, our class has worked extremely hard to produce an entertaining show for you. We have decided to turn the tables on the Gonzaga student athletes, so now it is their turn to provide support for the clubs who are usually cheering them on in the McCarthy Athletic Center. I hope you enjoy the rest of the show, and now let's go back to Spencer and Amelia in the live viewing party.
Hey guys, welcome back to the live viewing party. How are we feeling in here today? Yeah! If you can hear, they are pretty excited to be here, as are we. But with me, I have Kristen McNeely, next year's captain of the Bomb Squad. So, Kristen, tell us a little bit about how Bomb Squad has shaped your time here at Gonzaga.
Oh, gosh. Bomb Squad has absolutely became my Gonzaga experience. It's what I look forward to here most. It's my family on campus, and just the opportunity to dance and all the energy that it brings is just my favorite part about GU.
That's wonderful. So if your club walked away with the grand prize of $500, how would that benefit your team next year?
We're completely student-led, and we thrive mostly off of donations and our fundraising that we do throughout the year. So this opportunity would allow us to not only update our jackets that we have had since 2004, we would be able to bring in some outside choreographers to help better our skills, and additionally, we would love to continue competing, and so the funding would go towards that as well. And overall, we're just so thankful to have this opportunity to just compete for our team.
Thank you so much, Kristen. Good luck.
And now I'm here with Kennel Club President Sharon Greer. Sharon, how are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
How would you define Kennel Club and its role in the Gonzaga community?
Kennel Club is the largest student-run organization on campus, and we bring together a bunch of people from different majors, backgrounds, to come together and support student-athletes. So that's what we do.
Awesome. And what would you guys like to do with that $500 prize?
I don't know about anyone else, but I'm all about food. So we'd love to bring that money to give our members a lot more food opportunities for waiting outside on games and soccer games, volleyball games, all that good stuff.
Great. Thank you for being here today.
Yeah, thank you.
And last but not least, we have Bulldog Band member Nolan Woodard. So Nolan, how has being in the Bulldog Band shaped your time here at Gonzaga?
Well, the Bulldog Band was kind of the first group of people that I met on campus, so a lot of them became some of my closest friends. And then with traveling at the end of the year to support the basketball team, so I really got to hang out with a lot of them more. And just became a really close group of friends, and we all hang out outside of the band program, so it definitely has kind of allowed me to really get involved in the community and the school spirit.
And how would the Bulldog Band benefit from $500?
Well, when we go on the trips and traveling, a lot of the time we're kind of stuck in the hotel because we don't have the outside money to be able to do like stuff on our trips. So we want to actually use our money, like example, when we go to Vegas, we want to go see like the Red Rock Canyon and actually do cool, fun band trip stuff on our traveling trips.
Very cool. Well, thank you very much. And thank you guys for tuning in. Keep sending those tweets to see your favorite club walk away with $500. Back to you guys in the studio.
Well, I'm so glad to hear what all the clubs would do with the money, but we wouldn't even have that prize if it weren't for the wonderful people at Savory Creations. Thank you so much to the Takazawa family. Now, it's like a fun game we got coming up. We went all over campus getting academic trivia questions from some of the coolest professors on campus. Contestants, remember, you guys can't answer anything. It's got to be your social network who alerts you to the answers. We're going to find out how smart those clubs are. Here we go with Core Challenge. Question number one from Father Patrick Harton.
Well, in the New Testament, there are 27 books. Which of the apostles wrote 13 of those books?
Which apostle wrote 13 books in the New Testament? Thank you, Father Harton. He is one of two priests we have from South Africa. He even met Winnie Mandela. I saw that the Disney princess raised her hand first.
Shannon Greer says Paul.
Shannon Greer is absolutely correct. There's 100 big points for them. All right, core challenge question number two. Let's go, Professor Robert Carriker.
During the War of 1812, Francis Scott Key wrote The Star-Spangled Banner while observing the bombardment of Fort McHenry from a ship in the harbor. In what city's harbor is Fort McHenry located?
Professor Robert Carriker, interesting cat. This guy has done a little hike called the Rim to Rim to Rim. That's where you go across the Grand Canyon and then back again. Holy mackerel. Merida, you are just really, really quick on the trigger.
Jordan Sanders says Baltimore.
Baltimore is absolutely correct. Holy mackerel. Kennel Club and Kacie forging into the lead. Let's see what can happen with core challenge question number three.
The phrase, the whole nine yards, is historically a costume term. When a man ordered the whole nine yards, what garment was he purchasing?
Welcome to campus, Leslie Stamula. She's new in the theater department. Two master's degrees this brilliant woman has. She minored in classical voice. She says one of the things that she's really, really liked so far here is taking part in Much Ado About Nothing. Very, very talented costumer. So we have Bree Baumann. You think you have the answer?
Yeah, from Christian Ashton, the collar.
It is not the collar, Bree. Connor and Kacie, I'll give you just a couple of seconds here. Yes, Kacie?
Sharon Greer says the Scottish kilt.
It is not the Scottish kilt. It's actually a three-piece suit. All right, let's see if we can get back on board here. Let's go to core challenge question number four from Dr. Alan Scruggs in chemistry.
The atmosphere of the Earth is made up of many different gases. Which gas is the most abundant?
the most abundant gas? Good question. We hear that Professor Scruggs is a flannel fashionista, always wearing stuff like that. Who had their hand up first? You guys be... Bree, all right, what do you got?
From David Wessinger, yeah. I have nitrogen.
It is not nitrogen. All right, we had anything? We had hydrogen here. And I'll tell you what, make a note of that because, holy mackerel, if we have this, we want to make sure that we got the scores right. All right, core challenge question number 5. Here we go. It's a math question.
If the pattern continues as 1A, 2Bs, 3Cs, and 4Ds, what is the 100th letter that will come up in the pattern?
Holy mackerel, A, B, B, C, 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 D, 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 and he wants to know what the 100th letter will be. Well, you know, the question came not from a math professor. Rob Eminger is actually a senior math major. As soon as he graduates in May, he's going to go start a program to teach. Kacie, I think I saw your hand go up again first.
Dylan Graff says W.
W is not the answer we're looking for, Connor.
Mama Griff says N.
N is correct. Way to go, Connor and the Bomb Squad. There's 100 points for you. Very, very well done. I didn't think anybody was going to get that. I thought we were going to have Coach Krause actually get that one. All right, quick scoring update. Kacie and the Kennel Club, 300 points. Connor and the Bomb Squad, 250. And Bree and Bulldog Band, 100 points. Up next, a very special guest. I talked about him before. He's an integral part of the basketball scene here at Gonzaga, a prolific author who basically rewrote the basketball rulebook. Coach Jerry Krause is ready for his guest lecture segment. But first, let's go to a couple more of our brilliant students, Madeline and Kelsey, in the Tweet Suite for an update on your votes.
Thanks, Dan, and welcome to the Tweet Suite, where your voice can be heard. I'm Madeline McCarrow.
And I'm Kelsey Morgan.
Earlier in the show, you heard Dan introduce the three questions that you, the audience, will be voting on. Voting will take place via Twitter, and the question that is tweeted the most will be answered in a half-hour-long special this Thursday. To recap, here's what those three questions were. First off, does my major define me?
Second, will campus construction ever end?
And lastly, what goes on in the life of Campo?
We want to hear from you. Make sure to tweet in your support for the question that you want to see featured on the half-hour answer show this Thursday. Make sure you use the hashtag APD2015. Let's look at some tweets that have already come in.
Samantha Driscoll asks, what does Campo do when they're not letting people into dorms? As somebody who forgets my key all the time, most of my interactions with Campo have been when I'm locked out.
Yeah, that's a good question. Cooper Vincent says that he wants to know when the construction will end because he says he's going to miss being woken up early every day to the sound of construction.
Cooper, do I sense some sarcasm in your tone?
A little bit,
Maybe a little?
I think a little.
Mackenzie Spiller says that if she had a dollar for every time a family member asked her what her major was, her tuition would be paid. Mackenzie wants to know, does her major really define her?
Can definitely relate to that situation. There's still time. Make sure you tweet in your support for your favorite question and use the hashtag APD2015.
That's all from the Tweet Suite. We're going to take a short break, but make sure to stay with us and we'll be right back.
I'm here with broadcasting students 303 class that actually had the responsibility of coming up with the question that Professor Dan will answer on Thursday. What will your show look like if your question is chosen?
If our question, will campus construction ever end, is chosen, we will be examining Gonzaga's future building development and the fate of some of our age-old structures. In our show, we will interview the heads of GU music and theater departments who will inform us about the Wilson Performing Arts Center. We also have Chuck Falkenberry, director of the Hemingson Center, answer your questions via Twitter about GU's intended growth.
Very good, and how about you?
We'll talk a little history about Campo, as well as getting students' feelings about how they feel about Campo. And then we'll also go on a ride along with Campo and see what their daily activities are. And then we'll finish with an interview.
And so our question is, does your major define you? So we're trying to see how personal a student's relationship is with their major. We'll talk to students and professors about stigmas behind certain majors or rivalries. And we'll also see how Gonzaga helps undecided students choose a path and a major that's correct for them.
Looking forward to what question will be answered.
Ah! So straight! Have you seen Ben's tiny car? Totally straight.
Oh, this is so straight.
Can you believe Professor Stevens today? He was being so straight.
Oh, this class is so straight.
Man, you don't want to go see that. That movie's super straight.
What does that even mean?
Do you even know what you're saying when you say that's so gay? Think before you speak.
Those longboarders are really starting to get on my nerves.
Bikers and scooters, too. They act like they own the sidewalk.
Yeah, earlier I was walking around, and I saw a skateboarder. He was coming at me real hot, and my friend was like, whoa. Then he just ran right into me. Then I looked at him, and he said, my friend told him to share the concrete. So then I was like, yeah, share the concrete, bro.
Yeah, people with wheels need to share.
The competition is really heating up at the Ask Professor Dan Show. Quick score update, we have Kacie in the lead with 300 points, representing the Kennel Club. Right to you, Dan.
Thank you very much, DMC. And a scoring correction here. It, in fact, is nitrogen that is the most abundant gas in the atmosphere. We're going to award 100 points to Bree and the Bulldog Band, and the race is tightening. Well, this is my favorite part of the show, where I get to introduce you to an inspirational figure on campus. The man sitting next to me has written about 30 books. He invented the three-point line, the breakaway rim, but tonight, his resume is complete. Say hello to Gonzaga's Director of Basketball Operations, Dr. Jerry Krause. Thank you so much for coming. And I gotta, you have taught math, you've coached, you've written books. What is the one aspect of your career that you would like to repeat, perhaps?
Well, more contact with students and athletes. I think that's the richness of being a teacher or coach.
Is there a difference between coaching
no.
and teaching?
No. I think teaching is coaching, coaching is teaching. And I think the essential part of coaching is the goal of striving to become a master teacher.
Yeah, I think you've really, really done that. Let's give the contestants a chance to earn a couple more points by learning a little bit more about your past. So, contestants, Coach graduated from high school in 1954. I'm going to play you a song that was in the top 10 in that year, and I want you to tell me the name of it and who sung it. Let's listen to it for just a little bit.
I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Hello, hello again. Shaboom, and hoping we'll meet again. Oh, life could be a dream. If only all my precious plans would come true. If you would let me spend.
Do you remember that one? Don't say it yet. All right, well, we'll give them a couple of seconds to think about that. Where was high school for you?
Cedar Bluffs, Nebraska, which is a spot near the Platte River in eastern Nebraska, yeah. Which no one knows about.
What kind of a kid were you in high school?
Immature, like most young people, and but pretty curious.
And was basketball a big part of your life back then?
No, you know, I was just trying to figure out life.
Yeah.
And I was not an accomplished athlete, but sports and especially basketball, I thought became something that was significant and yeah. saved my life, probably.
Saved your, that's a strong statement.
That is a strong statement.
And you know, it's something that you really, really can pour yourself into, I suppose, can have that effect. Okay, Kacie, once again, you think you know the answer. Who was that song by?
Sharon Greer says it's by The Crew Cuts, titled Shaboom.
You are going to need to buy Sharon Greer something really, really nice, because that is absolutely correct. Another couple of hundred points. So, do you remember that song?
I do remember.
Shaboom, Shaboom by The Crew Cuts. I remember Crew Cuts. I remember hair. let's move on to your college life. Now, again in Nebraska. Of course, where is a corn-fed boy like the coach going to go to school? He went to the University of Nebraska. Contestants, take a look at the screen, and I'm going to show you the mascot of the Corn Husker. Just like we have a mascot and his name is Spike, That guy has a name too. Let's see if your social media networks can figure out what that mascot's name is. But Coach, Nebraska almost didn't work out for you. Well, in fact, you made a pretty poor bet your freshman year.
That would be a mild statement. I was not too mature. And I got in a contest with four other classmates to see who could miss the most hours of class.
Oh, man.
That probably wasn't a wise decision.
I hope none of them are like surgeons today or anything like that.
Well, we all got kicked out of school, so I don't know how they ended up.
It didn't end there, though. That was a lesson that really, really smarted, and those are the ones that you remember. So what happened next?
Well, I really thought I was stupid, and I did do some stupid things, but I wasn't necessarily stupid. Mm-hmm. But I went to a small state college, Wayne State College, enrolled late, got a wake-up call from the dean of students who urged me to do better and became my mentor, registered me for all of my classes, introduced me to every professor.
Walked you around, literally.
Around, literally. He became the president of University of Nebraska at Kearney later on. He was a tremendous mentor for me.
Fantastic. Connor Griffin, somebody in your network knows the answer. Who is the Nebraska mascot?
Sean Palermo told me that it is Herbie Husker.
Herbie, very nicely done. There's 100 points for Connor and the Bomb Squad. So after college, you taught a little bit, but the really interesting turn in your career came in the early 80s when you wrote your first book. And we mentioned that the coach has written, you know, more than 30 of these things. So contestants, I'm going to put three titles up on the screen. Take a look at those. Coach Krause has really only written one of those. You have to figure out which is the real one. How the Three Changed Me, The Basketball Bible, or My Life as a Coach. Now the question I want to ask you, Coach, is the first book, Basketball Skills and Drills.
Well, at that time the title was with a different publisher. It was really Better Basketball Basics, mm-hmm. but it became Basketball Skills and Drills, the longest running fundamentals basketball book in history.
Holy mackerel. And do you wonder why that one when all the other books?
No, I don't wonder about that at all, because it was fundamental skills, and that's the basis for both good programs, and coaches around the world recognize it, and it certainly wasn't my name or reputation. It had to be the content.
Yeah. And apparently it hasn't changed in all those years.
Well, it's evolved, let's put it that way, and I have developed a gift of making the game simple and easy to learn, which every coach needs.
Yeah, true enough. All right, Kacie, you have somebody who thinks they know the answer to that one. Which one did the coach actually write?
Colin Calhoun says Basketball Skills and Drills.
Well, that is true, but that wasn't one of the choices. So who? Connor, you were second. Which book did your coach write? Oh, my Lord.
I believe it is...
change your answer.
Basketball Offense Source Book.
Bree, you got a response?
Yeah, from Christian Ashton, it's the Basketball Bible.
The Basketball Bible is correct, 100 points, and yeah. So that was rather a bold statement, the Basketball Bible.
Well, you know, there's hidden knowledge, and why I had entitled that, it's a compilation of resource material that's unpublished in any other places. It's theses and dissertations from around the world. Mm. And I thought unknown knowledge to anyone is valuable enough to call it the Basketball Bible.
Amen. Amen. We've talked about many of the contributions you have given to basketball. You know, you were part of the three-point line, the breakaway rim. Ryan Edwards likes the fact that you put padding underneath the backboard. Thank you very much for that one.
Yes.
Of all the gifts that you've given, which one were you most anxious to share with people who didn't have it?
Well, I don't know whether you can pinpoint any one contribution like anyone. I just believe that you... develop your unique talents, you get to know yourself, and then you give it back. You serve serve the world, actually. And I served the basketball world, I think, as well as anyone in history.
You served them well for a really, really long time. You're retiring now. This is your swan song on our show. We're so honored. Anything you want to share with us about what you'll
do? I'm retiring from the men's basketball program. Mm-hmm. I have a very heavy part in an initiative to what we call evolutionize youth basketball in this country. We have the largest dropout rate in history of youth sports. People don't know that the system is crumbling at the bottom. And I spent last weekend in Colorado meeting with some like-minded people, and I think we have some solutions that may help reverse that. So we call it evolutionizing the direction of youth sports, and especially youth basketball.
I think you're the kind of man who, if you put your mind to it, it's going to happen. God bless you. Thank you
you've
done for basketball and for Gonzaga as well. Okay, contestants, it is time for you to make your final wagers as you guess the winning question. After the break, we'll find out which lucky club will get to take home the prize of $500, courtesy of Savory Creations. We'll see you after the short break. You're watching the Ask Professor Dan Show on GUTV.
Thanks for reminding me.
Hi, I'm Samantha Takizawa, the judge for the Ask Professor Dan Show. This year, the $500 check for the winner is being sponsored by my parents at Savory Creations, Doug and Bev Takizawa. This year, not only are they giving the money, they are also sponsoring the pho bar that's happening at the live viewing party. Savory Creations sells chicken broth concentrates as well as pho broth concentrates, and you can find more on www.savorychoice.com. My dad, Doug Takizawa, is also a Gonzaga alum. This just goes to show how supportive our alumni are to our current students. Thank you so much for your donation. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back to the last score update of the show. Kacie and the Kennel Club is still in the lead with 400 points. Let's see who will take home that $500. Dan?
Okay, first we got to find out how they're betting. I'll tell you this, everybody is all in. Kacie and the Kennel Club bet 400 points. Connor and the Bomb Squad bet 350. Bree and the Bulldog Band bet 300 points. And you know what? Each one of them bet on a different question. but the one that Bree bet on wins. Will this construction ever end? Congratulations to you. Congratulations to the Bulldog Band. $500 courtesy of Savory Creations. Thank you so much. And so I'll answer this now. Will the construction on campus ever end? The answer is, I hope not, at least not yet. According to the university's growth plan, there's some really cool stuff going in all over campus. There are plans for a new performing arts center, the Jesuits are getting a new residence, and of course, the new Hemmingson Center. I know it's a little bit of a drag walking around construction zones all day long, and it might not be the prettiest thing to look at while buildings are going up, but Thane, if you're watching, I just want you to know it's A-okay with me that the construction continues, at least until you build us a new media center over here. We have lots of ideas of how to spend your money. But that's just what I think about that question. If you want to know more about the topic, be watching Thursday night at 7 for a half an hour show devoted to teaching you about Gonzaga's expansion plans. And then stick around because at 7:30, a very, very special half hour special all on the Hemmingson Center. Check us out at watchgutv.com. Thanks so much to Savory Creations. Good night.
I'm not surprised, not everything lasts. I've broken my heart so many times I'd stop keeping track. Talked myself in, I've talked myself out. I get all worked up, then I let myself down. I've tried so very hard not to lose it. I came up with a million excuses. Thought of every possibility, and I know someday that it'll all turn out, and you'll make me work so we can work to work it out, and I promise you.